Ladies and gentlemen, come gather around, come gather around, come gather around. Today, we're going to look at arc welding safety, namely the stuff you want to wear to take care of your body. Right? Let's go! So we're at the welding bench in my home shop. I've got some of my equipment here that I use to keep myself safe. We have the same stuff in the school shop. I'll touch on that a little bit later on. Whatever you're doing, whatever you're welding, and wherever you are, you want to take care of your body. The bright light from arc welding is not good for your skin. They say that 10 minutes of welding arc exposure is like 10 hours of sun exposure. I'm part Scottish, so I pretty much burst into flames and burn to the ground. If you're like in a welding booth and you're going, I smell pork, that's me welding. Okay? It's like even SPF, SPF 30. 30 times your skin's natural protection. 30 times zero is still not much. Okay, back on task. Arc welding safety. I tend to wear a shop coat or coveralls to protect my skin. Well, before I built my shop, I worked out of my house garage and I was doing a bunch of welding in the summer. And the summer here where I live is fiendishly hot. I know it's Canada, but when the snow melts, where I'm at, we often get to like 95, 100 degrees sometimes in the summer. And I don't have air conditioning in my house garage, so I'm wearing like shorts under a shop coat. And the light coming from the welding while I was building a tubing bender sunburnt my legs, and it was not comfortable at all. So currently in my shop, I've got better insulation, it stays cooler in the summer, and I wear coveralls to protect my skin a little bit better. The best welding gloves are made out of leather, because leather does a really good job of protecting you from sparks and burns and everything. And in each welding area, we've got helmets hung up here, so you can use those. We've got leather, yeah, there. Leather jackets, usually some leather aprons to help you in the welding booth. We also have handy little tips, how to set up the welder, tips on using, burning the welding rod as far as you want to go, and what to set and adjust on the helmets. So be sure to take care of that. So when you're welding, leather is probably the best thing you can be wearing here. Someone else's skin to protect your skin is always better. Isn't that right, Clarice? I've got a variety of gloves that I like to use. I tend to use these a lot. They're called roping gloves, cowboy gloves. They're just thin leather and they fit really well and they still allow your fingers to have some dexterity to do whatever you're doing. I use these for just about everything and they're convenient to weld with. Downside, they don't protect your wrists at all. So I often get a little strip in there, sunburnt my wrists. I've also had spatter hit my I'm allergic to children bracelet and I have to pick that off. Better is a set of gloves like this. These are TIG welding gloves and they give you the same thin, small, tight fitting fingers that give you the dexterity that you need for TIG welding. But I cherish these and I don't want to wreck them. So I tend to only use these for TIG. And they have the gauntlet which protects your wrist. So that's a good thing to have. And you want it kind of this way so any boogers fall down here and don't go into your clothes. At this end of the tool rack, you're going to find the leather gloves. Leather gloves are in this section here. They're going to look like this. Also, a gauntlet style glove. I think I get these from Princess Auto and they will protect your wrists. They don't give you quite as much dexterity as the TIG gloves, but they work fine for stick and fine for MIG. If you've been here for a while, you've probably seen me using this. Not usually when I'm welding because it's under the mask, but when I'm grinding a lot. This is designed to fit under a welding mask. It's made by a company that sells welding equipment, and I use this underneath a mask if it's really smoky. I do have ventilation. Let's talk about that. So it's not going to be a good show for you here, but because it's the dead of winter, I've got all of my ventilation system blocked up and insulated to keep the cold out because we got down to minus 23 or so. This little weird thing up in the wall here with the big handle coming down, I pull the handle, this thing hinges off the wall and inside is a louvered air inlet, okay? When I go to turn on my barn fan, which is way up here in the peak of my roof, when I hit the switch to turn this on, the vents here open first. When those vents have fully opened, a contactor turns on the barn fan and it moves a lot of air through the shop to clean it out. So if I'm doing a lot of welding, I will turn that on for sure. I also have a rheostat or a speed controller for that. And if I need to move a little bit of air, I have it low. If I need to move a lot of air, I usually have to open up the roll-up door as well, because that thing moves a ton of air. In the school shop, you're gonna find the ventilation switches are over here in the welding booth area. That's kind of weird. And we have a couple different switches that we need to switch. So we just push this out of the side, practice that mad tight literacy skills, and check this out. Don't switch these. Just leave them alone. Instead, you're gonna go here. We turn on general, we turn on the welder, especially if you're gonna do some welding, and we turn on the forge. Don't worry about this one. We'll worry about that if we're actually doing foundry work, but those three are usually pretty good. And as an aside, if you're gonna do some blacksmithing in the forge over here, check this link on how to light the forge, and to get me to give you a demo, that will not physically turn on until the ventilation system up here is actually operating. If that's not switched and flowing air, that's not gonna move. So if it doesn't light, that's why. Just gotta wait for it, takes a little while. But that's where the fan switches are. This welding helmet and me have been around for a long time. They don't last forever, especially when you drop a truck on it. So, I have a new helmet. So let's talk welding helmets for a moment. I recommend an auto darkening helmet like this one. They've become so cheap, why would you not? And it makes your welding a whole lot better. When you're looking for a helmet, a couple things I recommend. Get one that has four sensors. There are two sensors here beneath this solar panel, and there's two sensors down here. Highly recommended. I have had helmets with just two sensors, and if you're blocking one, you lose 50% of the signal to tell this to darken. So four is definitely good. Haven't seen any with six, but I don't spend a lot of money for helmets. They usually come with an extra set of screens for the outside and the inside, just to protect it from whatever gets in there. The inside ones don't usually cack quickly, but these guys get covered with welding booger nuggets and stuff, and so when you have a hard time seeing through it, just get another screen. All auto darkening helmets that I've found come with the ability to adjust the shade, and generally the smaller the number, the less dark it goes. I have found with stick welding I needed a little bit darker, and with TIG welding I needed a lot lighter, just to make it easier for me to see. Depends on your eyes, and if it becomes uncomfortable, turn it up. When I was younger, I'd turn this all the way up to 11. But now I tend to be around 9, because my eyes just don't adjust to the light or the dark like it used to. I'm getting old. I got one foot in the grave and the other on a banana peel. Another feature you want to look for is delay, which kind of keeps the thing dark for a time after you finished welding and then brightens it up again. I find with TIG welding that's kind of handy if you have a little bit of a fluctuation in current, or if you're welding in such an area that you may occasionally obscure the sensors. I don't want it to like think I'm done and then undarken the helmet and my eyes are like, ah, oh my gosh. Another one that I like to have in a helmet is sensitivity, which is right here on this particular one. Sensitivity is just like, how sensitive is it to the flash of light? I've tended to have this on low sensitivity, so it just kind of darkens and stays, and it's not like fluctuating weird. And I might be doing it wrong, but play with this until it works the way you want it to go. This particular one has a grinding and welding mode, which is kind of nice. So if you're welding something and you're like, ah, crap, I gotta grind that out, you don't have to take the helmet off, just flick the switch to grinding, grind it, and then remember to switch it back to welding when you're gonna weld it, or it's gonna hurt. Nothing lasts forever like the cold November rain. Sometimes the back end gets broken and you can usually buy replacement skull clamps, whatever this is called. You can also get replacement straps in here as these get kind of filthy and disgusting. This one looks like it's held on just with little pins. When it's gross, I'll find out how to remove it and see if I can clean it and whatever I can do to replace it. But I can usually get a couple years out of those. I also like a helmet that goes down fairly well in here, because I often forget to snap up my coveralls or shop coat, and more than a few times I've sunburned the V of my neck right here from weld. So sometimes my sweetie is like, are you welding? Well, how can you tell? Burn right there. See these little tabs in here? I mean, a big screen is beautiful and wonderful to look through, but these tabs become important in your early 40s. They are for this guy called a cheater lens, and you can get these. It's like reading glasses for your welding helmet, okay? And you kind of need those the older you get. Even if you don't need reading glasses, try some. It makes everything biggie size and makes it easier for you to see what you're welding. So you might fall in love with these even if you don't need reading glasses. These just fit in like so. You slide them in and you can usually adjust it to whatever height your eyes are on your head. And then you've got this extra little lens. Definitely a cool thing. I like that. Welding fumes might age you. I'm actually 26. So we took a look at arc welding safety equipment. Whether it's MIG, TIG, or stick, doesn't really matter. The same three things kind of go on. You want to protect your eyes, you want to protect your skin, you want to protect your lungs. And you don't normally see old welders, you don't normally see old body men either. So take care of your body because it's the only one you have, okay? As always, thanks for watching. I'm gonna go do some welding. Take care.